Hey guys, what's up? It's Naturally Nate here, and I just want to talk about some of the things that's going on in the YouTube world. There's some controversy going on, so let's talk about it. But first, before we get into the video, I just want to say welcome back if you are subscribed and stuff like that. So if you've seen my videos before, or if you're subscribed already, give this video a thumbs up or comment down below whether you liked it or not. If you're new here, however, why don't you hit that subscribe button so you can keep watching my videos and be updated whenever I post a new one. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. And now let's get right into the thick of it. So, in case you don't really know what's going on in the YouTube world, there's this new policy going on about demonetization slash monetization of videos. It used to be you have to have 10,000 total hits in order to actually, or views, in order to actually be able to monetize your stuff, whether you had one subscriber, 10 subscribers, you know, zero subscribers. As long as you had that 10,000 view slash hit on at least one video, of all lifetime, you would be able to monetize a video. Well, now YouTube has come out and said that you need to have at least 4,000 hours worth of watch time, as well as having 1,000 total subscribers. So as you can see, a lot of smaller YouTubers are now being upset with that. As for me, however, I can't really say I'm upset with that because I haven't been able to monetize anything yet. I'm still below 100 subscribers. You know, I haven't gotten any of those lifetime views or anything like that. I'm still growing. I'm still learning. I'm taking this more as an opportunity to kind of still try and narrow down my niche, kind of figure out who I am as a YouTuber, stuff like that. So, yeah, it still kind of stung a little bit, I guess I could say. But I'm taking it more as a learning opportunity than rather, you know, trying to burn down YouTube as a whole and start a riot against them. It's more of me trying to figure out like, oh, okay, well, I just need to work harder and better at my profession, at what I'm trying to do on YouTube. However, as you can see, there are a lot of people who are not very happy about this at all. You know, there's tons of people that's saying, oh, this is them targeting us smaller YouTubers. You know, they're just trying to make our life harder. You know, I now just reached the milestone. I'm now just making $100 a year. As you can see, there's a lot, I'll post some things here that I've seen around the internet. There's a lot of good reasons out there, and there's a lot of bad reasons that, you know, that people are upset. One of the most kind of influential creators out there, as you might know him as, you know, H3H3 Productions or Ethan Klein. He's been under so much trouble lately. He's a really great guy. You know, he's really funny on YouTube and stuff like that. He's also very funny on Twitter. You know, he just recently posted, I personally think the new YouTube partner changes are a good thing. It's kind of insane to let anyone post and make money. It encourages copyright infringement, extremist, Spider-Man and Elsa creeps, and other shady stuff. It's what caused the adpocalypse to begin with. I know it sucks if you're affected, but the amount of money a new creator stands to lose is at most around $100. On the other hand, this will have a huge impact on protecting the new delicate YouTube ecosystem, and once you make it, you'll be on solid ground. Passionate creators should not be dissuaded by this. This is a positive change by YouTube, in my opinion. It takes us a year to get 1,000 subs. It wasn't at all about money then, and over the time we made about $100. So as you can see for Ethan there, it took him about a year to make 1,000 subs, and he only made about $100. So a lot of people are worried about this, like, oh, that's $100. That's so much money. That's so, you know, it's not. And you're relying on those $100 a year. You should be trying to figure out some other type of stability, because you never know with the internet. YouTube could be gone in a year. You never know. They could sell to someone who doesn't care. It's just what happens on the internet. If you're really relying on the $100, you need to find some other type of way to make money. YouTube should never be about the money. YouTube should be about your creativity, your passion to make videos. It should never be about making money. That's why I started. That's why some of the top creators started, you know. They were bored. They wanted to make videos, you know. They just wanted to be creative. They wanted to be passionate about something, you know. That's kind of what you have to take. You have to take this new thing with a grain of salt and be like, okay, you know what? It's a punch in the gut, but it's time for me to be more creative and more get myself out there more. Let's go into what some other people have been saying about this whole thing. Keemstar, for example, has said things such as, if you can't get 1,000 subs and 4,000 hours of watch time in a year, then do you really believe you should make money from YouTube? I see so many people upset, but let's be real. If YouTube is your job and you expect to be paid but can't get 1,000 subs, you suck at your job. Now that's a little bit more harsh, but Keemstar is known to be harsh. But he is saying something that's true. You know, if you've been on this, you know, you've been on YouTube, you've been on this website for a couple of years now, and you haven't made 1,000 subs, you haven't made to 10,000 subs, something like that. If you've been on there for 3 years, 5 years, you know, and you're not making more than $100 a year, it's time to reevaluate what you're doing, you know? And like I said, you know, you can take things that I'm saying with a grain of salt, because I haven't made a single dime off of YouTube. You know, I'm still below 100 subscribers, but I am just taking what I've been learning so far, from the research I've been doing, from what I've been looking at online and stuff like that. There's just a lot of things to learn from that I don't think people are actually doing, and this is what I'm here to speak to you guys. And I'll go into a little bit more detail about what you guys can do, but for right now, like, there are times when you should reevaluate what your channel is, you know? It's not necessarily stick it to the man. You're like, oh, I've uploaded 1,000 videos, 4,000 videos, and I'm still under 1,000. Like, I don't care. I'm still just gonna be making what I want. Like, no, it's not. That's not what it is. You know, you need to make videos of what people are gonna like. You can't just say, I'm gonna make videos of what I want. If no one's watching it, then you have to rethink what you're making. You know, it's as simple as that. This other YouTuber by the name of @FeliciaLachere, hopefully I'm saying your name right, says, so because I only have 800 subscribers, I can't monetize my videos. What's with that at YouTube? I'm 200 away from the threshold, yet my beauty videos are no longer monetizable. Thanks, Logan Paul, for screwing everyone over. Again, it all depends. How long did you get those 800 subscribers? Did it happen within a couple months? Did it happen within 8 months? Or did it take 2 years? You know, if it took 2 years, then you need to rethink about what you're doing, you know? But if it's taking you 3 months to get those 800 subscribers, then there's no need to worry. You're gonna get up to 1,000 pretty soon, you know? You're gonna reach that threshold so soon. You're gonna be totally fine. You know, there's no need to worry about it. So many of these small YouTubers are so worried about making money is what's the problem. You need to not worry about making money, because, you know, it is a kick in the gut. Like I said, it is a kick in the gut. You know, it's like, oh man, I'm not going to be able to make money on the thing that I want to do for as a job. I want to do this for fun. I want to do this to spark my creative side, and I want to reach people. I want to talk to people. I want to be creative with people, and if they enjoy it, awesome. I want to take them along with this journey, and if I make money on the side with this, awesome. You know, it's that mentality that you need to have when making something like this. When you don't have that mentality and you start getting frustrated because you're not making the money, you know, you're not doing that kind of stuff, that's when it really starts to get to you. Okay, I just turned off my fan. Hopefully this sounds a little bit better. I'll use some noise reduction stuff in my editing software, and hopefully it'll sound a little bit better. But anyway, that's a great segue into what I want to talk about next. Here, I just want to give some tips and some tricks on to how to better your channel. I know I keep saying this, you know, take everything I say with a grain of salt, because I am a small YouTuber. You know, there are some small YouTubers who are way better than me. You know, they're way stronger than me, you know, they have way more subs than me. I look at probably at least 10 to 20 small YouTuber accounts a day to see how I can improve, or even to look at how they can improve. And to my surprise, it looks like there are so many small YouTubers who don't do their research. And I don't know if it's the mentality of, I just wanna start and make money, or if they just genuinely just start, or if they just don't want to do the research, you know, I don't know what it is, but they're, the whole idea is like, what can you do about this? You can't do anything about the rules, sadly. You know, the rules are there. They may change later down the line, but there's nothing you can do. You know, I've been seeing petitions about trying to fire the CEO of YouTube. It's not going to happen. You know, Google probably pressured them to do this. Sadly, they're not going to get fired. This rule won't change within a week. It'll stay the same probably for about a couple years. So the best thing for you to do is to reevaluate and think about what you can do for your channel. So let's go into some tips and some little things that I learned from other YouTubers and from watching other YouTubers, from just thinking. So let's go into some things that I learned. Here's some tips and tricks that I learned and that have kind of helped me grow. Like I said, I started kind of back in September of 2017, but I really started posting now in January, kind of the middle of January. And I really have seen some growth and some more views and stuff like that. I'm gonna just kind of tell you guys what has helped me and what I've kind of seen help my channel grow, even though it's just been a little bit, but it's still a development in my channel. So whether or not, here we go. The first thing that I really want to talk about it is you have to stop doing the sub for sub thing. It is very unprofessional. If you want to become a professional YouTuber, you have to stop doing sub for sub. It looks really tacky. I understand wanting to support smaller YouTubers and saying, hey, if you sub to me, I'll sub for you. You know, it seems very small, very minor, and things like that. It looks unprofessional. YouTube doesn't allow it. And if you do somehow become very big, very popular, very famous, very fast, it's not okay. It's against their guidelines. I would much rather grow on my own. If someone says, hey, I sub to you, can you sub to me? I will more than likely say no. But if someone says, hey, I sub to you, can you just check out my channel? I'll look at their channel, see if I like it, and if I do like it, I'll sub to them. You know, that's what YouTube is. If you like their content, you like their channel, then you sub. If you don't like their stuff, you don't sub, you know, because you're giving false hope to someone by subbing to them if you're not gonna watch their stuff. Because what YouTube is, it's not about sub count anymore. It's not about views anymore. It's about watch time. Watch time is what gives you money. You know, it's not about how many views anymore. It's all about watch time, subs, and everything. It does not matter anymore. So when you sub to someone that you know for a fact you're not gonna be watching their stuff, it's giving them false hope. There are so many YouTubers that I watch, I'm like, holy crap, this guy has 1,000 subs. This guy has 500 subs. And then I look at his videos, and I'm like, oh my God, he's getting 12 views on his stuff. He's getting 20 views. You know, I'm like, how? He has 200 people subscribed to him. It's just proof that sub to sub is out there and it's not working. Don't sub for sub because it's not working for your channel. You know, it's gonna make your analytics look bad. If you have 2,000 people subbing to you and they're just not watching your content, it's not good. It's just that idea, that mentality, that's not good. It's not gonna get you anywhere in life. You know, people like Shane Dawson, Markiplier, Rhett and Link, Jacksepticeye, they did not get anywhere from doing, hey, if you sub to me, I'll sub for you. No, they might have said, hey, if you collab with me, let's do a couple videos together, let's grow together, stuff like that. Hey, I really liked your stuff. I subbed you. I really liked it. Keep up the good work. And then that nice comment will want to make the person go check out their channel and check out their stuff and maybe sub. And if they don't sub, you have to be humble enough to not care if they don't sub back. That is a major thing, is you have to be a humble YouTuber. You cannot get upset at someone for not liking your content, not subbing back to you. You know, if they give you critique, you have to take it and be like, oh, okay, thank you so much for giving me that critique. So number two, you have to learn how to perfect your craft. You know, it's kind of that niche thing. I'm still learning what my niche is. You know, I kind of thought I wanted to be a gaming channel. But I'm learning that some of my gaming stuff is not getting as many views as some of this kind of stuff is. So I'm learning. I'm still trying to figure out what my niche is. And you have to learn what your niche is. Don't be a super general channel. You want to be super narrowed down so that way you get an actual audience. You want an audience. You want to perfect your craft. You want to perfect your videos so that way your audience will know to go to you. Your audience will like your videos, will know to come to you, will subscribe to you, and know that you will produce content that they want to watch. If you're just producing general content, stuff that goes all over the place, kind of like how I'm doing right now, but like I said, I'm still trying to figure things out. They might just watch one of your videos and go away because you're saying, oh, none of this other stuff is for me. You know, none of his other stuff is for me, except for this one video, so I don't need to subscribe. I don't want to watch. You know, so it's things like that that you kind of have to think. So really focus on perfecting your craft, perfecting your niche, you know, on your channel, and really focus for that. And you also really want to focus on having a schedule. Scheduling your videos is very important, you know. You want to focus on at least having, you know, 2 to 3 videos a week, probably. Those videos are always on the same day, always around the same time, so that way your audience knows when to come back to your channel, you know. So the third thing that I really want to talk about is really working on your videos, making sure your videos are the best that you can produce, you know, editing them to their fullest extent, making sure they look really good and making sure they sound really well. You know, it's not necessarily all about the camera, you know, visuals are important, but the audio is actually probably one of the more important aspects of a video, because if they can't hear you, they'll automatically click away. And it is proven that if you can't hook someone within the first 5 seconds of a video, they will click away. Edit your film, you know, edit your audio. Make sure it sounds really good. You know, if there's background music, background noise, learn how to edit that out. Learn how to make sure it sounds good, or else people will just click out. The next thing that's really important are thumbnails. You have to have really good thumbnails. I know I've been really trying to put thumbnails in. You know, some people say put as much effort into your thumbnails as you put into editing your videos. Now that can be true. Sometimes thumbnails can be easy to make. Sometimes they can be harder to make, depending on like if you want to have a picture of yourself in, because then that involves taking a picture of yourself, then cutting yourself out of the picture, putting yourself into the thumbnail, maybe putting an outline of yourself. So then there's a lot of other stuff that you have to do within the thumbnail, but pretty much there are certain things you can do, like Photoshop is definitely the number one editing software out there for thumbnails, I would have to say. I highly recommend trying to make the most professionally looking thumbnail ever, because that's their first look at your video, is the thumbnail itself. They don't see your video first, they see your thumbnail first. That's what makes them want to click on your video. So you definitely want to make sure that your thumbnail looks the best that it possibly can. And then the last thing that I want to talk about kind of in this general area are tags and titles. And even descriptions. So these all have keywords that play into when someone is searching your video. So your title definitely kind of has to have some kind of keyword, you know, so like when your video is going up, look at what titles of other videos there are. You know, so if you're doing like a tutorial, like how to do this, how to do that, what are things like that, kind of mimic that title in your own way to make sure that people, it ranks, it gets onto the first page. Put the title of the game there, and then put like, most frustrating game ever, ? Or like best game ever, ? You know, something like not too clickbaity, but just like enough clickbaity that someone might be like, oh, I wonder what this game is. And someone might even type best, like what is the best game ever? What is the most frustrating game ever? And because I have that in the title, it will then try and put my video up there for them to see. So that's another thing for you to think about as well. And then for description, you want to have a decent sized subscription or description, so that way they can at least know what your video was about, especially if you're not a known YouTuber. What I do for my subscription, I put at least like a tiny little paragraph and at least like 2-3 sentences, as well as a little catchphrase saying subscribe to my channel, go to my other social media stuff. If you have any products that you show off in your video, maybe put a link to your products, your description, as well as, especially if you're part of the Amazon partnership stuff like that, that's a good idea, because then you can get money if they click on those links. And then for tags, you want to put in like what your video is. Is it funny? Put in funny. Is it comedy? Put in comedy. What is your video? Is it about beauty? Is it how to? Put in beauty how to. What kind of makeup do you have in it? What kind of video game is it? Is it a walkthrough? Put in, you know, Super Mario Brothers walkthrough, Super Mario Brothers game through. Put in Kylie Jenner lip kit, you know, put in stuff like that. Reaction to blank, you know, put in those kind of keywords that someone might look up to or look up at. And that can also help people find your video, is in the tags section, or even putting in YouTubers' names who have already done similar videos to that. So like, I know for my gaming stuff, I put in tags such as PewDiePie, Jacksepticeye, Markiplier, Game Grump, especially if they have played the game that I'm playing, as that could help my video get into one of the suggested rows on the side. So those are some things. There are definitely a lot of videos out there saying how to do that. I highly recommend doing your research for it. You know, there's really good YouTube channels out there. I'll put them in the links down below. Video influencers helps a lot. That's a ton of research I've done with that. And Think Media is another really good one. They're both the same kind of people. One's more of a collaboration of two YouTubers, and one is just himself. The last thing that I kind of want to lead you with is, if you can market yourself, you know, get your Twitter account, get your Instagram account, post every day, use your hashtags, talk to people, collaborate with people. Don't do sub for sub, but you know, at least just talk to people, get them interested, say, hey, I posted this video, check it out. You know, just put little polls out there, get people interacting with your account, get them talking to you, get them interested in you, get them knowing who you are, because then that's ultimately is what gets people to your channel. So that's basically all I kind of have to say. I know this whole kind of YouTube thing sucks, but ultimately there's nothing we can do about it besides building ourselves up. You know, we can try and help each other's out by, you know, commenting on their videos and trying to sub for them. But ultimately we have to focus on ourselves and making sure that we're producing the best content that we can, and we making sure that we are putting it out there for other people to see. If you have any questions, please leave a comment down below. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, there's a little subscribe button that you can click on it, and you will keep updated on the videos that I post. Again, thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Again, I am Naturally Nate. Stay natural and bye-bye!